Hello everyone, welcome to HR Electrical. In today's video I'm going to describe about the industrial control panel and its component, and hopefully it's going to be very helpful for the beginners who are new to the industry. So if you like this video, please subscribe my channel and I will keep posting more videos about more industrial stuff. So let's start having a look on our control panel. So this white plate in the back is called the base plate for the control panel. Base plate or the back plate is where we're gonna mount all the component of our control panels, and these plastic pieces, these ones, they are called the raceway. They are attached to this white back plate with the help of the screws inside these holes. So these raceways are really important in order to run our wires and keep the wire neat and clean and in an organized way. As you can see, I'm working on the wiring part on this panel and I have run the wires in the raceway in neat and clean way. So in a real environment, raceway is going to be something look like this when it comes from the manufacturer. And all these components, they are mounted on this steel plate. We call it a din rail. So it looks something like this. So let's start describing the component of this control panel so you guys have the basic idea what are their function and how to identify them. And this is just a small control panel for my industrial application, and they can be really big with more components inside it, but I'm going to describe about this control panel for my application. So let's start with the exploring the components on this control panel. This thing, we call it a fuse holder, this white little box. So this fuse, the purpose of this fuse holder is we have to install the fuse something like this into this fuse holder, and we close it back. So this fuse is the main power inlet for this whole control panel. My main power will come on top of this fuse and it will be distributed through this fuse to these terminal blocks. So these terminal blocks, they come in a different color, different levels, but especially this green one, they represent the ground terminals. Ground terminal means all the ground wiring on these components, they will go on this green terminal. Then we have this gray one, gray terminals are basically the junction point of the wires where you connect all the wires together. And this gray terminal is a two level. By two level I mean, as you can see it over here, we have two levels, one and two. So I can put a wire, one on the top and one on the bottom. And after these terminals, we have these fuse holders again. And these are the smaller fuse holder. They take the glass fuse inside. So let me show you something like this. This is the glass fuse that will go inside this. And we will close it back and it will complete our circuit. So these fuse holders, they're giving a power supply to this power outlet, Ethernet switch, PLC and DC power supply. So now we have this electrical outlet inside the panel. We need this outlet for purpose of let's say laptop charging, or you want to put some kind of a light or something while doing the troubleshooting and stuff. So that's why I installed this electrical outlet inside my panel. Next to electrical outlet, I have the Ethernet switch. It's just a basic Ethernet switch. It have the ports on it, 5 ports, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So these ports are basically for extending my Ethernet connection. So I use this device for communication purpose with the PLC. So I can use this Ethernet wire and connect to my PLC for communication purpose, or either with my laptop for downloading and writing the program. And next we have the PLC. This is the click PLC from Automation Direct. So it has the inputs, outputs and the analog inputs, outputs card on it. So I can use this PLC according to my application, and I can program the inputs and output accordingly, however my application demands for. And on the end you can see this little guy is the end stop. End stop is gonna be looking like something like this. we use this end stop so we can organize the component and put the proper spacing between them, and we can lock them in a position. And next we have this DC power supply, this one here. So this DC power supply, what it does is it takes the 100 volt or to 240 volt AC and give us a 24 volt as output. So why this DC power supply is important? Because there are many components, they work with the 24 volts. So I cannot put 110 straight on them. If I put 110 straight on them, they will burn. So I need some kind of a converter. So this device here, it will convert my 110 to 24 volt DC. Now I have the relays next to my DC power supply. These relays, as you can see, is written 24 volt on them. So they work with a 24 volt DC, which will be provided with this DC power supply. So these relays, they will be energized with the help of the outputs from this PLC. And these will be energized according to my application requirement. Let's say if I have to activate something, valve or something. So whenever, let's say the relay number one will energize, it's gonna activate my valve, which is connected in the field outside. So whatever are the outputs from these relays, they're going to be coming to these terminal blocks. Now again, this is a different type of terminal blocks. It has three level: level one, level two, level three. So this one is a three level, one, two, and three. I can put three wires, one on top, one in the middle, and one in the bottom. So you can see this was, as I explained earlier, it has a two level, one and two. I can put two wires on this, and this one I can put three wires on it. The fuses inside this fuse holder, they play an important role to save our components. Let's say in case of a short circuit or there is any troubleshooting issue, something happens, the fuse inside them will blow out first, and it's gonna save our all these components. So that's pretty much about this component inside this panel for now. And I'm working on the wiring part of this. Once I finish with the wiring part, so I will make a second video where I will show how these wires are being run and distributed among these components. So if you like my video, please subscribe my channel, and I will keep posting more industrial stuff. And hopefully it's gonna be helpful for the beginner personnel, especially in the industry. Thank you.